morning and welcome to St. Jude. If you are visiting with us or if you are new to the parish and would like to be recognized, please stand so we can welcome you. Any visitors, any newcomers? Welcome to St. Jude. Our priest for this morning's Mass is Father Andrew Semler, and assisting him and giving the homily is Deacon Craig Malone. Please open your hymnals to hymn number 660. Please stand as we sing our opening hymn, Sing Praise to Our Creator, number 660.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us prepare our hearts to be open to listen to the Word of God and to receive the Holy Eucharist. We do so by recalling to mind our sins, asking the Lord for pardon. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We give you thanks for your grace.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. So at this time, I invite our children to come forward for the liturgy of the word with children. Okay, so we pray that may God bless you as you listen to the word of God this morning and as you hear about Jesus being the light of the world. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, share your bread with the hungry, shelter the oppressed and the homeless, clothe the naked when you see them, and do not turn your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. If you remove from your midst oppression, false accusation, and malicious speech, if you bestow your bread on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then light shall rise for you in the darkness, and the gloom shall become for you like midday. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The just man is a light in darkness to the
to the upright.
shines through the darkness for the upright. He is gracious and merciful and just. Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. The just man is a light in darkness to the upright. He shall never be moved. The just one shall be an everlasting remembrance. An evil report he shall not fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. The just man is a light in darkness to the upright. His heart is steadfast, he shall not fear. Lavishly he gives to the poor. His justice shall forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory. The just man is a light in darkness to the
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity of words or of wisdom, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling. And my message and my proclamation were not with persuasive words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of spirit and power, so that your faith might not rest on human wisdom, but on the power of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything, but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Many years ago, I went scuba diving at night, and we were navigating a course using a compass. The water was cold, visibility not very good. As my dive buddy and I were swimming, all of a sudden my compass needle jumps and points in a completely different direction. So I start following that direction. Then a few minutes later, the needle moves again in another direction. I'm like, wow, this is strange. And so I keep swimming, and then all of a sudden my needle starts spinning around and going in all different directions. I stopped and I looked, and then I noticed my dive buddy was no longer there. I found myself all alone. Have you ever been there? Eventually my compass settled down, so I started to follow that again, hoping it would lead me in the right direction back to my dive buddy. And then all of a sudden, as I was swimming, it just went pitch black. It was eerie, an unbelievable experience. I was afraid at that point, something I hadn't encountered before. So I kept swimming, hoping to see the light. And when I didn't, I decided to turn around 180-degree turn and swim back in the direction I came from. Well, I kept swimming, still no light. I swam even further than I did coming in, still no light. I'm lost at this point. I'm running low on air, not sure what to do, so I decide to surface since I'm completely disoriented. So I follow my bubbles up to the top, and as I'm ascending up, all of a sudden I hit rock. And then I feel over here and on the right, and I realize that I'm trapped. I can't surface. Panic begins to set in. Fear starts overwhelming. My heart's pounding. I'm consuming my oxygen at a rapid rate. So I decided to just start crawling out. I'm laying on my back, pulling along the way, and then eventually I made it out and saw the light. I swam to that light, and then I surfaced and found my dive buddy. God's got us, doesn't he? Amen. No matter how alone we are, how lost, how dark things seem, God's got us. This is one story I shared, but have many others. And I'm sure many of you have your own stories and experiences as well. You know, looking back at that time, I never thought to turn to God for help and to pray. I never even thanked God for seeing the light of a new day. And when we find ourselves in those situations, some may think, I sure am lucky. Thanks to my dive master skills and experience, I'm okay. Or maybe it was my keen sense of direction, my awesome situational awareness and decision making. But now I know better. Christ is our Savior. He is the light who lifts us up out of darkness and despair. By the grace of God, I stand here today proudly declaring that my compass is set towards eternal life, towards being His disciple. And in today's gospel, Jesus reminds us that compares us to disciples as being these three images: salt, light, and a city on a hill. And when you dive deeper into Scripture and you look at these three images, I love to go to Scott Hahn and see what he has to say. He's one of my favorites. And he points out that these images represent the identity and the vocation of Israel. God aligned His kingdom with the kingdom of David and His son by a covenant of salt, which represents purity and permanence. Leviticus chapter 2, 13. Israel was given a mission to be the light to all nations, where God's salvation would reach to the ends of the earth. Isaiah 42, verse 6. Jerusalem was a city set on a hill, high above all others, drawing all nations toward the glorious light streaming from her temple. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 2. Every Christian is called to fulfill that same mission. And we can all ask ourselves today, are we true Christians? Are we that salt and light to the world? Or are we faithless, bored believers, depressed disciples, the chosen, frozen in fear, hiding our faith under a bushel basket? So how do we become that salt and light to the world? And we heard in our first reading today, the prophet Isaiah tells us, thus says the Lord, thus says the Lord, this is what God wants of you. Share your bread with the hungry. Shelter the oppressed and the homeless. Clothe the naked when you see them. Remove from your midst oppression, false accusations, and malicious speech. Then light shall rise for you in the darkness. And when we take care of those in need, we are that light in their darkness. A few minutes ago, we all stood and sang the Alleluia, which means praise the Lord, as a way of praising God and preparing our hearts for the Word of God and the Gospel. Our cantor sang and led us in singing, I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. and our own salvation is predicated on bringing God's light and life to others. This is how we're measured. This is how we're judged. Our Lord invited Saint Teresa of Calcutta to be the light of Christ to the poor and the dying in Calcutta. And one of the stories about Mother Teresa's work described a man who visited her home in Calcutta just as the sisters were bringing in the dying and the sick from the streets. The visitor watched one of the sisters care for the patient and saw how tenderly she cared for that dying man. She didn't miss a detail. And after carefully watching the sister, the visitor turned to Mother Teresa and said, "When I came here today, I didn't believe in God, and my heart was full of hatred. But now I am leaving, believing in God. I have seen the love of God in action through the hands of that sister, through her tenderness, through her gestures that were so full of love for that wretched man. I have seen God's love descend upon him. Now I believe." So where's your compass set? And are you being that salt and light in the world? As Saint Mother Teresa is quoted, "Not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with great love." One announcement. I want to thank all of you who have already participated in the 2023 Bishop's Annual Appeal for Supporting Catholic Ministries. If you have not already, there are envelopes from our commitment weekend last week in the pews. And we invite you to participate, or we invite you to be part of our support for these important Catholic ministries. You may place the filled out pledge card in the regular Sunday collection, or the basket at the back desk in the narthex. In the narthex, we also have pencils. For those who are watching online or would like to use a credit card to make a pledge, on our homepage, you will find a link to the annual appeal website. Thank you again for your support.
Let us together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, who was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He has ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us lift up our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
For the church, that we may be a light to our world, and that our words and deeds may be instruments of healing and transformation for our society, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they continue to search for ways to heal ancient wounds and find ways of promoting peace and justice for all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to be salt and light, that our faith will guide our participation in the issue of society and in our political discourse, so that the gospel values may open new possibilities for the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who reach out to the poor and those in need, that they may see the face of Christ in those whom they serve and never grow weary in offering love and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater care for our common home, that we may grow in our respect for the earth as God's gift to us and work to preserve it for future generations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the bishop's annual appeal, that through our gift, the appeal may be successful and in thanksgiving for all those who support the work of the church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and who are dying, and for those names written in the St. Jude Book of Intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially Vincent Lockley, Arthur Boyer, Cindy Wilson, Arthur Kariv, Yvonne Arosa, Maria Uloa, Aurelia Rojas, Charles Brown, Joe Rice, Richard Averius, Johnny Panko III, Sina Smith, Maria Arizola. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Tuan Trinh and Mao Qua, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, receive the prayers of this community that we lift up to you. We lift them up to you through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn number 657 in your hymnals. Number 657, sing your praises to the Father.
Sing your praises to the Son.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and his blood.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died. In your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our first communion hymn can be found in your white songbooks, number 107, number 107, Wonderful, Merciful Savior.
Thank you.
Your meditation hymn is found in your white songbooks, number 93, Soul of My Savior, number 93.
So we do have the following announcements. High school juniors and their parents, we have an opportunity for you. We are hosting a college prep night to help you guide you through the upcoming college application season. This event is free and will be on this Thursday at 7 p.m. All married couples, there will be a Valentine's dinner and dance on Saturday, February 11th. This event includes a catered dinner and a DJ to help you and your spouse have an amazing evening. The cost is $60 per couple, and you can register online by Monday. There will be a representative in the narthex to answer any of your questions. This year's Family Lent Workshop will be held on Saturday, February 11th at 9:30 a.m. It'll be a great event with prayer, reflection, and lots of crafts. Light snacks will be available. The cost is $15 per family, and you can register online. As we prepare for the upcoming Lenten season, we have added a new Lent section on our website. You can find resources to grow your faith, regardless of your age, and you can find activities and a calendar for the events of Lent. Join us in congratulating two of our deacons on their anniversaries. Deacon Robert celebrated his 10th anniversary on February 2nd, and Deacon Al celebrates his 10th anniversary on February 9th. So if you see them, make sure to congratulate them, and we thank them for their service to the parish. A representative from our local Catholic radio station, 910 AM, is visiting the parish today in the narthex. Please stop by and support Catholic radio, and you can do so by purchasing a raffle ticket for a chance to win a 2023 Mercedes-Benz GLA. Join our St. Jude Young Adult Ministry Group. They're going to meet this Monday at 7 p.m. in the Ledger Hall. So the young adults will come together for prayer and discussion, and it will be followed by an off-site social. You can see the website or contact Patrick McKenna for more information. Next weekend, the youth are hosting the Super Bowl of Caring. It will be used to support Feed My Starving Children. So if you'd like to donate, the teens will be at the exits next weekend. The Knights are also offering their annual Super Bowl ribs. Next weekend, they're making 250 racks, and they'll be available at the exits until they are sold out. The cost is $25 per rack. If you have any questions, you can contact Ronnie Sheehan. And this year, we are offering a pre-Lenten mission. So Father Mike Ford will be hosting a three-day mission next week. He will be preaching at all the masses. And then the mission is Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. So the 13th through the 15th. The final night will be a mass, oil blessing, and a veneration of an arm relic of St. Jude, our patron saint. So save the date, and hopefully you can join us for the mission. Let us stand and pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing the first and last verses of hymn number 615, number 615, Immortal, Invisible God.